oh gosh, I'm so glad that I have so many opportunities to tell them I love you. I'm so glad you're mine. I'm so glad that you're in our family. I'm so glad that you're here. I'm still so glad that I'm having breakfast with you this morning.
I keep hearing on the news over and over about the parents that went there and were able to get their kids, and those that had to be told that their kids weren't going home with them. And I can't imagine that if I was in their shoes as a parent, that my daughter wouldn't be coming home with me.
He's okay and everything.
You're devastated. My youngest son was in Sandy Hook School, and he was in a classroom right near where the shooting took place, and he was with a reading teacher, just him and the reading teacher, and she closed the door and took him into the bathroom. They sat on the bathroom floor until the police came and said prayers and just stayed very quiet until the police came.
If we messed up, she would tell us to do it again, but she would, like, encourage us to do better.
They did tell them to close their eyes. My daughter, of course, she never listens, so she didn't, and she's been talking about that a lot. She said, Mommy, I can't get that body out of my head. I keep seeing it.
Make an end here, like make it worth something, make it mean something, because you can't bring him back, but you can create change.
Gun control, strict, severe gun control. That's really all there can be. It's Second Amendment to bear arms, but that amendment was written 300 years ago, 250 years ago. Our forefathers never thought that it would come to this.